Well, in Southampton is Financial Secretary of the Treasury, Mark Hoban. Mark Hoban, first of all, does the deal commit UK taxpayers to pay up for Eurozone countries that are in difficulty?
Well, we've made it very clear that the UK government won't be contributing towards the strengthening of the EFSF, the bailout fund. And the Chancellor made that very clear this morning. It's a matter for the Eurozone to resolve.
Yes, but let's talk about the IMF. He made it very clear that he thinks, as a founder member of the IMF, we should be prepared to put more money into the IMF. That, therefore, is committing UK taxpayers to put more money into a fund which may eventually be used to help Eurozone countries.
Well, let's be clear at the moment that there's been no request for IMF resources, and the IMF can't lend money to the bailout fund. It can only lend money to countries as part of an agreed programme. What's been suggested by some is that the IMF helps administer the bailout fund or the special purpose vehicle that someone's talking about. That doesn't involve the IMF actually lending it money.
And the idea then that, that some people call suicidal, we heard in that film, that David Cameron saying that the ECB should be the one to lend the money?
Well, you know, I think the challenge is, Kirsty, trying to find the resources to ensure that the bailout fund is credible and it can not only help recapitalise banks if they can't find capital from markets or from their own governments, but also put a firewall around Greece.
So wait a minute, you don't need the ECB at all then? That's just out of the equation?
No, I mean, what's important is that the mechanism is there to ensure that the bailout fund is big enough and strong enough. And that's why, given that the Eurozone have ruled out using the ECB, they're now looking at other areas.
So wait a minute, so not using the ECB, in your view, the ECB will not be called on?
Well, that's what the Eurozone leaders agreed last night. And this is, I think, part of the challenge that Paul Mason referred to earlier on. What Paul Mason said earlier on was absolutely right. Last night's deal was good progress. What they need to do now is complete some of the detail to provide markets confidence and credibility that this plan is in track. And part of that detail is how will the ESFF be funded?
Now, let's talk about our banks. Are you convinced that our banks are secure at the moment?
Well, what the work that the EBA, the European Banking Authority, did demonstrate was there was no requirement for additional capital to be paid into British banks. And what we've seen over the course of the last 2 or 3 years is British banks putting aside more capital and also holding higher liquidity. And that's meant they've been in a better place to withstand this crisis than banks elsewhere.
At the moment, we've talked about the fact that it's more the French banks that are exposed to the write-down of their Greek debt. But what if other countries in the Eurozone need debts written down? British banks will then be exposed, won't they? They're bound to be.
Well, what the European Banking Authority did was to look at the exposures that each bank has to Eurozone sovereign debt and market to market. Yeah, and that's demonstrated where capital is required in places like Greece and Spain and France and Italy, and those countries where it's not required, and that includes Britain. So I think our banks are in a good place to withstand this. But of course, you know, the Bank of England and the FSA do regularly look at what's happening in our banks and to assure that they're still safe. But what we've seen is significant progress over the course of the last 2 or 3 years to strengthen the banks. That actually has kept our banks in a good place during this crisis.
Mark Hoban, thank you very much for joining us.